Welcome to my other office. I just came back from fantastic shoot in the Mont Blanc area of the Alps. I have shot a variety of images, including this one. I really like it because, well, it's an atypical climbing shot with the climber, Mont Blanc in the background, and this really awesome flare and small spindrift visible in it. In the photograph, there were a few elements I was not in control of, and that is the drone and the wires, and I removed them using the new repair layers feature. I'm gonna start by going to Local Adjustments tool tab and simply create a new clone layer. I'm gonna enlarge the area of interest with the zoom tool. I'm gonna select now to draw mask and adjust the size of the mask brush accordingly. I will first start by setting the source point, being somewhere at the level and next to the right of the drone, and start drawing a layer mask around the drone. When the operation is done, Capture One will apply the texture from the source point onto the target point. It is very easy to fine-tune the new repair layer functionality, and this is achieved just by moving away the source point with respect to the target point. So now I'm gonna focus on the wire part of the image, and I'm gonna fix it with the hue tool. It's a very good tool to match the tone and the color of the sky part. I'm gonna now finish off the image by adding the gradient mask to the sky. I'm gonna experiment with changing the levels and adding a little bit of punch with the clarity tool. I really like the following photograph because of the sense of a scale that it brings, the weather and the general drama. But I really believe that it can be further enhanced just by adding a lot of clarity. The clarity tool can be found in the exposure tool tab, and it actually comes in four different flavors. And I'm gonna use the new natural option. As you can see, the photograph is not really overprocessed, and there are no drastic changes in the overall saturation of the image. However, the micro contrast has been applied to various areas of the photograph, bringing the detail in the rocks and in this glacial area. And this is exactly the type of feel I wanted to achieve, a true drama. I'm gonna finish off this photograph by bringing more details into the climber over here. So I'm zooming in to make as precise selection as possible, but still do it quickly. I'm now creating a new local adjustment layer, and I will bring back the brush tool and really create a very, very raw selection around the person. I will go to High Dynamic Range tool, and I will drag the shadow slider all over to the value of 100. And what will happen is only the shadow luminance values will be affected, leaving the midtones and highlights untouched. And this is very important for this rough selection, as the climber is surrounded by very, very bright snow. This photograph has been taken on the cornice which overhangs the Glacier Jaune, and conditions were really harsh with swirling clouds around, and that actually helped to bring the drama in the photograph. The main issue of this photograph is the overexposure in the snow in the foreground and in the background, and this can be corrected with the HDR tool. I'm gonna go now to Exposure tool tab, and I'm gonna start working with the High Dynamic Range tool, and by adjusting the highlight slider to bring the snow exposure down. I'm gonna finish off this photograph by removing the crane in the background with repair layer functionality. I'm gonna bring more detail in the snow with the clarity tool. And ultimately, I'm gonna manipulate the sky with the gradient mask. I really like this photograph, as for me, it captures the essence of high altitude mountaineering under difficult conditions. However, I believe that we could bring even more drama by very simple manipulation. We can enhance the climate of this photo by adding more film grain. I'm gonna start by going to Details tool tab, and there is this new film grain tool. There are six different grain options, including Silver Ridge. However, I'm gonna use the harsh grain as I want to demonstrate the effect. There are two sliders available which control the effect, impact and granularity. I'm gonna boost both of them to the maximum to demonstrate the effect. And as you can see, especially on the rocky area and also on the jacket of the mountain guide, we have this very huge fine grain. However, I would like to match it against the smaller snow particles which were found around his ice tool. Hence, I'm gonna decrease the granularity and consequently decrease the size of the fine grain particles.